Welcome to Naples in Italy for the second day of action from the 2019 Universiade Shooting Competition. This multi-sport event brings together the world's best university athletes every 2 years. This year there are nearly 6,000 athletes from 112 countries coming to southern Italy. Shooting taking place at the Mostra d'Oltremare venue to the west of Naples. And today fans looking ahead to the men's 10-meter air pistol competition. These are the eight finalists. They're from six countries. Now, will there be Asian dominance again, I wonder? Italy, the hosts, are represented. Two shooters from South Korea, two from Chinese Taipei, and one each from Iran, China, and Slovenia. 112 countries represented here, nearly 6,000 athletes. Italy have the largest delegation, as you may expect, with 301 athletes. China have 198, and big delegations from the United States and Russia as we get underway. This is the second event in the pistol and rifle events. We had a winner from the Czech Republic on day one, Lucy Brazdova. It was a super event. It really was exciting. And one lesson we learned is the favorite and the best scorer in qualifying doesn't always go on to win, because the Indian Valarivan Elavenil was absolutely brilliant in qualifying. She actually broke the Universiade record, and she was the big favorite. She moved her way up. She was fifth, fourth, third, but couldn't quite overtake Brazdova. I wonder if we'll have something similar here. Eight shooters going for glory here. No doubt who's the local favorite there, Di Martino. He's also the tallest, 1.85 meters. Tall shooter is Di Martino. As you can see so far, shooting pretty well there, 40.1 in these early stages of competition. Jose Sepa of Slovenia going well in these early stages as well, but it is a marathon, not a sprint. And, go up to 24 shots in total. But the crowd will be absolutely delighted if Di Martino can go home with the gold. Home not far away, he's from Napoli. It's Di Martino. Train many hours, up to 6 hours a day. Focus is concentration, calmness, keeping still, breathing. So the top shooters actually say they can shoot between breaths. That's how precise this is. There's a lot of weight training involved, but it's not about really developing brute strength. It's more about balance. So let's look to see how things are after the first five shots. Di Martino is there with 50.4 after the first five shots, the only one to break 50 points. But Park Dae-hoon is lurking not too far behind. Second round of five shots just starting now, with Dario Di Martino the leader after the first set of five, with Park with a narrow favorite ahead of competition just behind him. Looking at the Chinese Zhang Boen. He's currently in joint third place. Martini coached by Vincenzo Grimaldi. He's also part of the national structure, where Roberto Di Donna runs training for shooters ahead of Olympics next year. Remember, not too late for shooters to make a claim for a spot in the Olympics. Countries have quotas built up during the World Cup events, and then national federations choose the shooters closer to those Tokyo Games. Now, Dario Di Martino is keeping his lead, but we've just seen a good 10.1 from Park Tae-hoon, and that's closed the gap by fully 1 point because Di Martino could only score 9.1. Here he is. Your pitcher will be disappointed with that 9.1 at this level. Just not good enough. He has to find that form that he showed in the first five shots. He was 50.4 after the first set of five. We are well into the competition now for the 10-meter air pistol competition at these Universiad, and an Italian is leading the way, but he's been overtaken now. Di Martino was ahead after five shots with 50.4, but there's a lot of pressure coming from shooters from South Korea, China, and Chinese Taipei. The Asians traditionally dominate this competition. I wonder if they'll do it again. Seen a 10.6 from Park. That'll do his claim a lot of good. Looking to go away with a gold medal for South Korea. Maybe shooters can pick their own pace for these five shots. It's with the 250 seconds. They can go fast, they can go slow, and everyone has their own style. It's a disappointing 8.6 for Cho. And we're at the end of the second set of five shots, and after 10 shots it's Park Tae-hoon who has the lead, 0.7 ahead of Di Martino, who's been overtaken, with Zheng Bowen in third. So South Korea, Italy and China leading after 10 shots. Now we're going to now our elimination stage, so the weakest two shooters will shoot off against each other. And the one who has the lowest over 12 shots after the first round will go out. So this is where we're going to go down from 8, 7, 6 to the final four, and then the medalists. Seventh and eighth are Paul Hosseini of Iran and Wang Weitai of Chinese Taipei. The gap is 0.3 points between those last two. So we'll take a look at that, but also see what's going on at the other end of the leaderboard. 10.6 for Paul Hosseini. So when he needed to come up with a big shot, he did. He's actually got the biggest score. And Di Martino, 7.1. Well, that's a huge disappointment, and that'll probably put him out of the medals contention. There is Di Martino. He knows he's made a huge mistake. So often happens in shooting, just one very bad shot and you're completely out of contention. So now Park Tae-hoon, after 12 shots, has increased the lead. He's got a 1 point, 4 point lead. And Zheng Bowen is now second place, and that very bad shot from Di Martino means he's slipped. And maybe at this stage we'll be happy with a medal of any color. All about consistency. And the Italian didn't show it that time, unfortunately for him and the local crowd. So the last two are both from Chinese Taipei, Guo Quanting and Huang Weitai. As you can see there, one of those is going to be eliminated. But it's looking very good for Park Tae-hoon. A world champion in the 50-meter team free pistol event in 2018. Five finals on the World Cup circuit. Seen a 10.8 for Park. He's just getting stronger and stronger, is the South Korean. He's going to take some stopping now. 121.4 points already. Well, the first shooter eliminated is from Chinese Taipei, Huang Weitai, in eighth place. We're down to the last seven shooters in the 10-meter air pistol final at these Universiad. And we've just seen Huang Weite of Chinese Taipei eliminated. And at the other end, Park Dae-hoon, who was the best in qualifying, going from strength to strength. He was the only man who broke 580 points. And it would really be a very brave man to bat against the South Korean. Now he's shooting smoothly, looking confident. But just takes out one or two poor shots, and one never knows. Only 8.8 for Kuo. It's going to be hard for him to stay in contention now. The other shooter from Chinese Taipei. 10.6 for Park. It's consistent. And, you know, Paul Hussaini of Iran's doing well. 10.5. He was in the bottom three after 10, but he's going up the standings. He's overtaken Di Martino and Seppa. And I was saying that Iran have a fine tradition in shooting and at the Universiade, and there could be a medal going to Iran. Let's see. But Park Dae-hoon, nearly 3 points clear, getting stronger and stronger. So who's going to be the next to be eliminated? After 14 shots, Park Dae-hoon way ahead, nearly 3 points. That's better from Di Martino, 10.4. Seppa, 10.6, the best from that round. And Zhang Bowen is going to slip further and further behind Park. There's no stopping the South Korean for the moment. But eliminated is the other shooter from Chinese Taipei, Kuo Kuanting, in seventh place. We are down to the last six shooters. In Napoli, Park Dae-hoon is way ahead of the rest. He's getting stronger and stronger. There's a real scrap for the medals. Zhang Bowen has just shot quite poorly in the 13th and 14th shots. Jose Seppa from Slovenia has actually shot very well with a 10.6 a few seconds ago. Only a 9.1 for Park. 10.8! For Park, 9.1 for Zeng, excuse me. If he carries on like this, there'll be no stopping him. A 10.5 for Paul Hussaini and a 10.8 for Lim. So really good quality shooting. We're now in the elimination phase to see who will be the third shooter to be eliminated. Will it be Italy or Slovenia disappointed? Dero Di Martino against Jose Seppert. Just scrapping to stay in this final. While at the other end, Park is way ahead and he's shooting beautifully. ...10.5 for Zhang. He'll be happy with that. A mere 10.2 for Park. It's a good by anyone's standards, but he's been shooting so well. Maybe be a bit disappointed. A 10.2 for Lim. And Di Martino will be disappointed with a 9.2.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
but it's just enough for Di Martino. Seppa is out. The sixth place shooter from Slovenia. Qualified third, you know, couldn't quite keep it up. So we're down to the last five. There are five shooters left in this final. Park, Zhang, Lim, Paul Hussaini and Di Martino, and no doubt who's the favourite. Park Dae-hoon living up to the billing of being the pre-tournament favourite, and certainly after shooting 581 points in qualifying, full of confidence. Let's see who will be the next to go out. So there's been lots of changes further down the rankings. Di Martino was second for a while. Paul Hussaini was up in third. And Zhang Bowen is just keeping on to second place. He'll be absolutely delighted, I'm sure, if he can go back to China with a silver medal. Just seen a 10.4 for Park. That kind of shooting we'll see him with gold. And Paul Hussaini, 9.8. He was the only one to break 10, you know, in that round, Park. Some nerves are at play now.
Decides fifth place. Di Martino needs to overturn a 0.7 to stay
So now we're going to see who will be the fourth to be eliminated. It'll be Paul Hussaini of Iran or Di Martino of Naples in Italy.
Start.
0.7 is the gap for Di Martino to overtake. So he has some shooting to do. Needs to shoot really well. Di Martino against Forsell. He's only 9.2 for Di Martino. That's not going to be enough. And Paul Hussaini shot really well, you know, 10.3. And it's the end of the Italian challenge. He's disappointed. But nevertheless, he can be proud of himself making the final. He only just made the final, Di Martino. And he's in fifth place in this final. And you can hear the ovation he's getting. So 18 shots gone, and Park's lead is just getting bigger and bigger, 6 points. Surely he can't be overtaken, but there's a really fascinating scrap for the medals. We've just seen this man, Di Martino, eliminated. Fifth place, just outside the medals. But Paul Hussaini, with that last round of shooting, has gone into the bronze medal position. And suddenly Lim Hojin has the pressure on his shoulders in more ways than one. Here we go. The shot's 19, 20, 10.3 for Zhang Bowen. Oh, it's a 10.7 for Paul Hussaini. Suddenly, Paul Hussaini has found the form when he needs it. And Lim Hojin certainly didn't with only 9.8. Really good work there from Sajjad Lafmajani, Paul Hussaini. Of the top four, Park still way ahead. Zhang Lafmajani and Lim. This is where the tension will ramp up because there are medals at stake. Three of these four men will go home with a medal, one won't. It'll be desperately disappointing. I would say fourth is the worst place to finish. Will it be Lim Hojin who will have that position, or can he overtake Paul Hussaini from Iran? To 9.8 for Zhang, 10.3 for Park. He's not going to be overtaken. Only 8.9 for the Iranian. So Lim maybe has a chance with a big shot. Here, he's at a 10.3.
Oh.
Well, Paul Hussaini, I was saying he found some form, but then he lost it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, fourth position is confirmed. Please give a round of applause for Korea.
It wasn't enough. Hussaini, even with only that 8.9, just enough. And poor Lim Hojin shot well there, but it wasn't quite enough, and he's going to go home without a medal.
That was really quite dramatic because Lim shot a 10.3.
it was for Lim, but poor Hussaini shot poorly, 8.9, but it was just enough. Look at that, 0.1 of a point. Desperately disappointing to lose out on a medal. That's such a small margin, but those are the margins of shooting sport. It can be that way. And the man who's edged out is Lim Hojin. So we know the medalists. They will be from South Korea, China, and Iran.
Start.
Park Dae-hoon marching towards a gold medal, while Zhang and Paul Hussaini scrapping for a silver medal. Realistically, it should be that way. And Zhang Bowen has got a 0.1 point advantage after that shot. A wry smile from Park Dae-hoon. I think he knows he's going to go to the gold medal unless he shoots very, very poorly. And there's no sign of that so far. So China in Iran, Zhang and Paul Hussaini will scrap out that position for silver. There is Paul Hussaini, he's a calm character. He's gradually worked his way up the rankings. Looked like he might actually be one of the first to go out, but he's found some form. But he's going to have to overtake the 1.4-point gap here, which really takes some doing, but you never know. You need something very close to 10.9, is the Iranian. No, 9.5. I think that's going to be enough. Zhang with a 9. And what about Park? Pressure off a little, 10.3. Well, some shooters shooting better without that pressure, and Park is going to get the goal. But the bronze will go to Iran and Paul Hosseini. Well, that's a really, really good performance by Paul Hosseini. Qualified 6 with 5.74 points. And he was just clinging on, showing some really good determination. He's got the bronze medal. Well done to Paul Hosseini in Iran. So we know the bronze medalist in this 10-metre air pistol competition, and unless something absolutely extraordinary happens, we know the gold medalist. It's this man, Park Dae-hoon, who's been absolutely brilliant all day. 581 in qualifying, and he's 6.6 points ahead, which is a huge gulf at this level. Just needs to keep it simple, not do anything wrong. 10.1 for Zhang, that's respectable. And Park, 9.9, that'll do the job for him.
Well, there's not much difference. 10.1 from Zhang. He's been very consistent throughout the whole final. But it's going to take something really extraordinary to overturn.
So the gap has been narrowed ever so slightly, but 6.4 points with one shot to go, one round to go. So final shot, there's no doubt Park Dae-hoon. He's going to go home with a much-deserved gold medal. Zhang Bowen will shoot and just hope for the best. Here we go. China against South Korea. The last round of shooting in this 10-metre air pistol competition. What a competition it's been. Zhang finishes with a 10.9. Well, would you believe it? It's not going to be enough, I don't think, but that's a brilliant way to finish for Zhang. What's Park got? The 9.8. But you can't ask for more than that. 10.9 for Zhang. But Park is going to go home with the gold, 9.8, easily enough. 5.3 the gap. And a huge round of applause for a man who's been superb all day. The qualifying, he was top by quite a long way in qualifying, 581 points. And he led pretty much from, after 5 or 6 shots. And there was no stopping Park Dae-hoon after that. And he's finished with a total of 243.8. And Zhang Bowen getting the silver. I think he'll be absolutely delighted with that, you know, because when you're up against Park Dae-hoon, a real top-class shooter, coming second is a really good performance.